Hope everyone's having a good Tuesday. SEC media days continue, but we got to stop for a moment and talk about a new commitment. And I love that it happens early in the afternoon. Thank you very much, Mr. Zion Raggins, wide receiver out of the state of Georgia. He's 5'9". He's 170 pounds. I know what you're thinking. Like, he's so small, but he's got elite SEC speed. I can say that now because this is an SEC class. So, but again, the 14th commitment of this class. Bumps us up to number 15 overall in the On3 composite national rankings. And we're just getting started, folks, because that's just today. This Friday, a lot more potential good news on the horizon. So just got to be patient on that one. But I have a feeling of 5 stars in our near future very, very soon. So I'll have the running back and also baseball. So got to love that. But overall, just... the momentum continues for Oklahoma. You know, you got Zion Raggins. This one was talked about for a little bit. You know, his commitment date. He didn't have a stream or anything to watch. But overall, just really, really like where things are going. So, again, 21st, got Taylor Tatum potentially committing. And the next one you only know for sure after that is a 3-star safety, Michael Patterson McDonald, on the 31st. Then the next day, there might be a commitment from Williams Winari on August 1st. We think that's what's going to happen. A lot of people think that. There's no graphic out there. There's nothing where he says it. So just a tiny pinch of grain of salt with that one. Just so I thought you said he's committing on the 1st. Like, a lot of people are saying it now out in the open. I try to keep it on the down low a little bit for people who do pay attention. But that's what's being alluded to right now. Now, Oklahoma's got a big party at the Palace meeting later in the month once, because we got the dead period for a few more weeks where there's no contact or no visits for recruits on campuses. But Oklahoma's hoping to finish strong at the end of July to really set momentum for August and September, because those are going to be 2 big months for Oklahoma as well. But overall, just really, 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 really excited about this get. You know, we got 2 wide receivers named Zion in this class. But this, just watching this guy's film, got elite speed. He runs like a 10-400 meters. So you translate that, that's like about a 4.3, 4.40-yard dash. You get him in the open field. The stuff that Lebby could do with his speed, very exciting. So the wide receiver room is getting a little bit more interesting. No, is it the super 5-star guys we've always wanted in the past? No, but the last time we got a bunch of 5-stars, none of them panned out. Blame whomever on that. One was one, clearly one's fault. The other was a solid guy. The other one just didn't live up to the hype. So 5 stars are great when it comes to wide receivers, but there might be 5-star wide receivers might be, at least from my perspective when it comes to OU, I swear those guys bust more than anybody for us, whether it's Trey Matuire, the 3 we got under Riley a few years ago. Something about 5-star wide receivers, man, I don't know what it is. We're so-so on 5-star running backs, like, because for every Adrian Peterson, there's a Jeremy Calhoun. So, it is what it is. That is the recruiting giveth, recruiting taketh, but got to keep going after him regardless. So, but yeah, like I said, Taylor Tatum's going to be on Friday, and winning that battle is going to be very, very sweet. Everyone is inching closer who are... The ones who are holding out hopium for USC are starting to let go. They're not quite willing to push the button and flip their picks on their official 24/7 crystal balls or On3 prediction machine or whatnot, but the pain is coming for them. They've talked a little trash about Oklahoma, like on their message boards, and said how great USC and Riley is, but this one is going to hurt them a lot when they have to push the button to flip their pick. It's coming. So... not much else to report. Quick PSA. There was a fake Deion Sanders graphic out there on Twitter talking smack about Brent Venables. So if anyone's asking me about that, it's fake. So I have no comments on it. I'm sure some of you have already posted a comment to the video about it already, but it is what it is. But yeah, I'm not, there's nothing to talk about. Although I will, the audio of Brent talking about Deion was true though. Basically saying, you know, Deion, I'm not like Deion. I didn't come in here and just like throw away a bunch of players. It's like, oof. So, but it is the truth. So, I mean, you know, you can't really fault Brent Venables for that. Anyway, I'm going to get back to watching SEC Media Days because it's kind of fun. We'll be there next year. We'll see how it turns out. I know we have some OU beat guys there that are getting the early checking out. But SEC Media is coming to Dallas next year, so pretty awesome there. So we're slowly taking over the state of Texas. But who knows? Maybe the SEC championship game will one day be in Arlington. Not anytime soon, but maybe one day down the road, maybe in the 2030s. Let's play this thing in Arlington, see what it feels like. All right, I'm stretching this out long enough. You all have a good one. Boomer Sooner. Recruiting keeps on getting better and better. Y'all have a good one.